This is a walk-around pond. The Grand Design Reflection 337 RLS. We'll start out on the outside, obviously. Full fiberglass front cap. Adjustable pin box. LED light over the pin box. The first redesigned breakaway switch in over 30 years. The first company to come out with it was Grand Design. You'll see it on everything else now. Moving underneath, we have the battery compartment. We have a light with a motion sensor on it. You're gonna find motion sensors throughout the coach. We'll point them out as we're going around. This is a completely sealed compartment, so anything stored in there is not gonna have dust or water problems. This is a vent off your battery compartment. Coming around to the side here, one of the two 30-pound propane tanks. The other one's on the other side. It does have an automatic changeover. Moving over, we have the one paddle latch with the magnet holding it open. We swing the door open, another magnet to hold this door. You have your 4-point auto leveling control right here with the manual override on it. There is motion sensor lights inside of here also. One on each side. 12-volt battery disconnect switch will show on the other side. This is our wet compartment. We have hot and cold running water out here. You have a pump switch here for the water pump. You have the manifold here that takes care of water for city water, power fill for the tank, winterization, sanitation, and also has the bypass on the hot water heater. Down below, we have the black water flush. We have the three termination valves right here for easy access. You don't have to get down on your knees. They do terminate out of a single dump with a light above it. This is where the sewer hose goes, so it's very close to where it needs to be hooked up at, not back on the bumper. Your 50 amp cord goes in here. With 50 amp service, you are able to run two roof airs. This does come with the prep for the second air, if it's not put on by the factory. Back of your furnace. 6-gallon gas electric hot water heater. Lights from inside. It is the fast recovery. Back of your refrigerator. We'll talk about the refrigerator when we get to the inside. We're gonna start using Goodyear Made in the USA tires. A manual override for the glide room to bring it in. We do have the gutters to keep the black streaks from coming down the sides. We have the 2¼-inch receiver hitch on the back with the 4-plug adapter. It is pre-wired for a camera. We have the ladder, full access to the roof. The roof is anywhere walking. Coming around the other side here, we have the awning that extends out 8 foot off the glide room. We have a 110 GFI plug here, and we have a receptacle for your satellite or cable TV. If you have a TV outside, this is the other manual retracting. Coming up here, we have the conventional RV step. It is also being, can be retrofitted with the step that folds inside the door. We have the standard fold-away assist. The other awning is out here. It does have the outside speakers. The other side of the pass-through. With the bigger door, it has double magnets up there. It has the pet leash holder right here. And you can take the leash right through the bottom here and out. There's that 12-volt disconnect switch. The other propane tank is in here. Now we will step inside. It does have the friction hinges on it, but it also has the hold open T-handle. As soon as you walk in the door, you'll see our 110 and 12-volt breaker panel with the converter. Little storage up above. Our control center. New feature this year, anytime there's power coming into the coach, this blue light lights up so you can see where you are able to turn on the 8 ceiling lights with the one switch. You're not fumbling around looking for it. Your tank heaters are here. Water pump switch is also here. And your hot water heater is here. One of the awnings is ran from right here. The side rooms are all on their own separate switch. So you decide which one you want to take out at a time. Going across, you have the 12 cubic foot gas electric RV refrigerator with access to 3 of the 4 doors, with the room being fully retracted. We go along the other side over here. We have the second year of the new cooktop, more of a residential look. It has the iron grates on it and the oval center burner for the high output burner. We do have an oven now that you do not have to put your head in there to light. It has its own sparker. It has the pantry here with a auto sensor light on it and glass on the front. TV comes in the coach standard. It has the electric fireplace, which has taken the place of the heat pumps. More efficient and does a better job of cooling the whole coach. You have an AM, FM, DVD player, and it is Bluetooth adaptable. And you have a place for a receiver if you want to have a satellite installed. We have 110 plugs on both sides of the couch. This is the trifold couch that makes out in a matter of moments. That's it. Put your head at either end. Putting it back away, a matter of moments also. We are now using the blackout shades. And that's all the way around on the coach. And they are the slow rise. And you want to bring them up. You do have windows that have ventilation on both sides of the couch. And the back window slides also. You have theater seating here that reclines way back. It has massage and heat and a light. Your furnace ducts are never on the floor, so you're not filling them up with everything off of your feet. They come off the sides. It comes standard with a booth dinette, or you can get the optional 2 chairs and the little bench on this side. It is movable and has full storage underneath it. You can also option in 2 folding chairs to go on this side. There is a 110 plug underneath on that back wall. And a place for storing cards, placemats, whatever you'd like to put in there. There's our light above the dinette. This is our other switch for the awning that is on the glide room. You do have ventilation on both ends of the glide box. We do have the sprayer. Let's pull out on the sink. Here we have the garden, or as they're calling it, a farm sink. You've got the pantry here. You've got 3 drawers. 2 more drawers on the side, storage drawer there, a partial drawer here because this is where your 110 and 12 volt and converter box is at. There is USB plugs back up in here, and there's 2 110 plugs, one on this side and one on this side. Your lights are right underneath there. As we move up the stairs towards the bedroom and the bath, there is a step light here for the evening, another motion sensor light there. Your control for your downstairs air conditioning is right here, and your furnace. There is only one furnace on this coach. This controls the fantastic vent, which is like a whole house fan. If you come up into the bathroom, it is a one-piece fiberglass shower, so there is no seams. Prevents any leaks. We do have the skylight. Plenty of neat room off of the stool. And a nice size medicine cabinet. And you have the glass doors coming across with the rainfall. Moving into the bedroom, You have windows on both sides of the bed, and they do have screens on them. We have a little storage underneath the bed, extra bedding, wherever else you want to put in it. Because it is almost a walk-in closet, it is prepped for a washer dryer. Would be the stack one, where you could put the washer on one side, the dryer on the other side, or use the combo, either one. There's a shoe rack in the back. The bar goes all the way across. It is backed for a second TV up in the bedroom. The hookups are right up here. This is your second air conditioner. The vents on the ceiling are adjustable for whatever direction, and you can close them off. The air conditioners are hooked in the same racetrack, so if you're running one of them, it is going to get the air to the other end of the coach, and your thermostat is right here for this air conditioner. You do have a 110 plug on both sides of the bed. That is for CPAP machines. That is a quick walk around.